reasons why we're doing this today is that a lot of people are talking about election law. They're talking about doing audits. They're talking about changing the way we do elections. The only people they aren't asking is the county commissioners, the county commissioners association. So what we want to do today is actually have some real election reform. Not something that's based on some political stance, not something that's based on putting some fictitious website or a story that they read on the internet, but true election reform, something that helps the voters. Because, quite blunt, I've run a little thin. I'm getting a little bit tired of my colleagues who have never stepped into an elections office, have never run an election, are coming up with schemes that would do nothing more than keep people from voting. You know, one of the things I'm proud of, my wife was in the military, my brother was in the military, my family's been in the military. They fight to give people the right to vote, not to suppress turnout. So what we've done as a two-term county commissioner myself, I realized very quickly that the laws and the bills that are being done in the future are not to help people to vote, but to only keep a certain few people are able to vote. So today what we're going to do is that we're actually going to work with those individuals that do the elections. We're actually going to talk to the county commissioners. We've talked to the statewide county commissioners as well. We've got their input. This is a bill that the only thing I left out of it, and my chief of staff and others said I couldn't be this bold, was I wanted to put in the bill that every elected official, before they could talk on election bills, had to actually go and tour an election office, that they actually had to see, stand with those volunteers. See, volunteers every year come out and they're honest, they work hard, Republicans and Democrats, and to have them attacked day in and day out over doing what I consider the greatest job. We're losing election directors from the counties because they're sick and tired of the lies that are being told. So what we're going to do today is that we're going to stand with those individuals that do the elections, those individuals from all 67 counties. And this bill today was not written by me. This bill today was written by the county commissioners. I worked with Mark Higgins and Mike Pipe to come up with this bill. This is a bill that helps the voters, but it helps across the board. And I'm just going to highlight a few things before we go on. It allows a 21-day pre-canvassing. Well, the reason that's so important is that if you remember leading up to the election, I had elected officials saying that, well, there's going to be problems, but they would not allow, many of the counties did not count. Center County was a guiding light in this one. They did the pre-canvassing first in the morning with volunteers, Republicans and Democrats, to make sure that there was no questioning at the end of the day. The second thing we want to do is have an elected minority and majority district canvasser inspector there to look over these ballots while they're done. Provide county boards of elections flexibility to establish where the ballot boxes go. I have colleagues who believe that you should only have 3 or 4 ballot boxes in every county. Well, let's be honest about it. Even the smallest of counties to only have 3 or 4 drop-off boxes, people would have to travel literally 100 miles round trip just to be able to do an early drop-off ballot. A risk-limiting audit. This was done in 2020. It was done effectively. 63 counties participated, 45,000 votes, and it came out perfect. Requires the county to be reimbursed. One of the things as a county commissioner, and the counties will tell you, every time we pass a law, you, the local taxpayers, end up picking up the bill. So if we're going to pass a law, let's pay for it. Let's not kick it down to property taxes that people can't afford. Provides procuring of absentee ballots. It makes the permanent voting list for those individuals that want to do early balloting. Maintains accurate voter rolls. Has the Department of State is directed to maintain a tracking system of qualified mail-in absentee ballots. These are the things that the county commissioners have asked for. This isn't a piece of legislation that's going to go out and try to do some political type of maneuvering. This is legislation that Republicans and Democrats alike can agree to. And this is a piece of legislation that will make it safer, easier, more convenient, but most of all, it will give the recognition to those individuals that do all the work. With that, if Michael Pike, the chairman of the board, would be able to say?
Yeah.